We are already day 34. Amazing how August is already here. So good to have you. Good morning. Happy Sunday. Your playlist is 5 Vishuddha. 5 Vishuddha. Setting up with a block and a blanket. And anything else that you need to feel supported and inspired. And so again, if Vishuddha is the space of the throat, this place where we hold our stories, the most important stories, the most important words are the words we're saying to ourselves. The little mutterings that I have before I begin to teach when I'm wrestling with the camera. And in my mind I'm thinking, I am not a cameraman. I am not a cameraman, and in that I am defining a boundary that says, I can't do this. It might be a more appropriate thing, I don't enjoy this. I would rather be teaching than diddling with my camera trying to make the setup square. And that would be a much more valuable thing to say. It wouldn't be useful. But it would probably be more valuable rather than saying to myself, I am not a cameraman. So notice when you run into something, that there's a place when I'm trying to show something to my mom on the phone and she says, oh, I can't. But we haven't even tried. But we've defined, I can't do that yet. Or it's inappropriate to have a cat in the picture. And I've decided that having that is wrong. And yet, that's just my words in my mind. And instead I come to my practice and I come to my mat and I can get into my body instead of getting into my mind. So rewrite those stories. Give yourself some possibility. And you might find you're far more able than you realize, and all of a sudden you're running off of cameras that are working just fine. So keep the stories open, keep it all free, and come to sit tall. Ready, Suk? Everything's better than that. Om Namo, I bow to everything outside of me, guiding me, healing me, holding me. Gurudev Namo, I bow to everything inside of me, rising to meet it all. Inhale. Om Namo. You have to move your cat. Or not. Palms down, tap your heels, tap your feet, wag your tail, settle your spine. Left palm flat, right hand overhead. There's your breath in. And coming down, breath out. Left hand. And down. Start right there.
the breathing follow the motion. Let the motion create some symmetry and some space. One more each side. And then just turn your palms over and soften across the chest and the throat and the mouth and the hands. And turn over hands and knees, a blanket beneath your knees if you choose. You find a cat-cow grounding your back, tucking your chin. Heels of your hands just under the edge of your shoulders. Drop your navel, lift your throat, and exhale it out. Find your way in and out. And then add the knee to chest. Right knee to chest and swing back. Exhale, knee in. Inhale, heel back. Bring your knee to your right shoulder and across to the left. Bring your ear towards your knee. And start to move more fully into the hip joint, through the sides of your spine, your neck, and your breath. Step your right foot wide, right foot flat to the floor. Find your fingertips just ahead of you and shift your weight back. Inhaling back up, settle into the outer edge of your right foot and fold in. Inhaling up, chest is broad. And then exhaling back as you go back a little bit side to side. Stretch across the top of your right foot, the outer ankle, the inner knee, the inner hip, out the arms and shoulders. Rising to step your right foot outside of your right hand, a block under your left hand. And big reverse circle. Using your hips, using your knees, using your right heel. And the right arm stays beside, but the hips keep going forward and back. So the right arm reaching all the way out of the right hip. Bend your right knee and lift your left knee to roll under your right rib. Lift your left hip. Bend your right knee. And then looking down, setting down. Cat-calf, round. So your right hand, right hip, right heel feels a little different. Making space. A little momentum. Let in the light. Left knee to chest.
And tip of the toe.
Exhaling in, inhale it back. Feel the swing of your thigh. Close your eyes. Just find the rhythm of your breathing. Left knee outside of your shoulder, crossing to the right behind you. Bring your ear towards your knee. And
Step your left foot wide in line with your heels. Come onto your fingertips
and shift your weight back.
Rising up.
Fingertips just ahead of you. Outer foot to the floor. Take your time going back. Notice.
Inhaling up.
And slowly exhale back. Little side to side exploring. The base of your left big toe, the base of your left pinky toe, the center of your left heel.
Outer ankle, top of foot.
To rise, left foot outside of your left hand, right hand to the block, and a big reverse circle. Keeping your left arm over your left ear, hips forward and back. Tuck your right toes under, lift your right thigh, revolve. Lift your right hip as you bend your left knee. And setting down, knees wide, toes together, child's pose. Rising up, sweep wide. Hands high, thumbs pointing back. As you widen your arms, turn your thumbs down. Take the backs of your hands to your spine and fold the hips back. Inhaling up, thumbs pointing back. And exhale, fold. In and up. Out and out. Right hand only. As you fold, look left. Left hand up. As you fold, look right. To rise. And to fold. Lead left. And turn right. One more each side. Downward facing dog. Base of the knuckles into the floor, knees soft, hips high, heels float.
Let the arms extend out of the shoulders right down to the base of your knuckles. As you straighten your arms, let your backs of your hips lift as though you're trying to sit on the ceiling. Base of the first finger knuckle, the pointer finger knuckle in the floor, base of the thumb knuckle in the floor, and wrap your armpits towards your heart.
And fold your blanket aside. Walk your feet to your hands, hands to your hips, and stand tall. Left foot steps back. Left hand high, right hand wide, right thumb turns down, and then the back of your hand to your spine, lifting your heart, hinge the hips and bring your left hand down. So with a little bend in your front knee, use the block under your hand, or if you don't need the block, use your fingertips on the floor. Sweep your hips to the left, finding center, drop your head. Here's our base. Lift your left thumb, lift your heart. Come to stand, inhaling up. And on the exhale, fold back down.
Inhale up.
And fold.
One more.
And follow it out and down. And as you fold, turn your navel to the right.
Even bringing your nose outside of your right shin. The right ribs roll open, the right shoulder rolls open. The left back thigh lifts. Bend your right knee, step your left foot up, left hand to hip, and stand tall. Let it go.
So the work of the posture leaves your body. You come to the present moment. You are finished. You are free. Stepping your right foot back. Right hand high. Thumb points back. Left hand wide. Thumb points down. Back of your hand to your spine. And then fold.
Set up with a block under your right hand as needed. Sweep your hips to the right. Hips up and back to drop your head. Here's our exhale. Right thumb up, rising.
Reaching out of the right heel, folding.
Inhaling up.
And down.
One more. Feel the asymmetry your body is working to maintain. Hips sweep to the right. Your nose outside of the left shin. Your navel turns to the left. Lifting through the backs of your hips to lengthen and open the backs of your legs. To the center, left knee bends, right foot steps up, hand to hip,
and stand, and let it go, let it through, let it be done. However it went, however it's going. Left foot steps back. As your right knee bends, hand sweep forward, warrior one. It's a little bit of a reach. Hands down, straighten the front leg, this is breath out. Bending the front knee, this is breath in. As you go back, anchor into the left heel and lift the left thigh, even as you come forward. So the back leg becomes this incredible ballast and support. Reaching back as you reach forward, now only the right hand up to reach. You're using the movement to open from your left rib to your left knee. Feel the left side front body beginning to lengthen. One more time. Back heel down, left hand reaches, square the hips, and reach forward. You're going to draw your navel back. Draw your heart back. Lift that left thigh. Put the work in your legs and drop your shoulders wider, softer, fuller. And from that width in your chest, now open the elbows and then open the finger joints and navel back and rib back and front knee bends. As you lean forward, step up, hands down, let go, be done. However it went. Right foot steps back. Sweeping the hands out, left knee bends. Here's inhale. Hands down, here's exhale. As you straighten your front leg, turn your navel to the left. Keep that turn as you reach forward. So that the navel turns left and the right thigh lifts. Now only the left hand down. And be more deliberate. You're smoothing your breath with your movement, and you stay to draw the navel back and the ribs. Firm your right thigh, lift it away from the floor. And now soften the shoulders, open the elbows and the finger joints. Draw your navel and your ribs back. Let your right thigh open. Step up and be done. Knees soft, hands down the backs of your legs, folding in.
And step your feet back, down dog.
Knees soft,
hips high, arms open. And knees down,
rolling over, flat to the floor, knees bent, tap your heels, tap your feet, left palm stays flat to the floor, right hand overhead, reach your hands apart, and the right down, look left, and the left hand overhead, and the left hand down, look to the right. So right hand and hips lifting up. And as you roll down, look left. Hips up, left hand up. And roll down, look right. Right hand and hips. Look left. Left hand and hips. And roll down. One more, right side. And down. Left side. And down. And pause. And turn your palms over. Feel through the arms and feel through the chest and the throat that this is changing, harmonizing your body, your mind. You turn right back over. In your dog, feel the length of your arms now, the space of your chest. And from the length of your arms, the new depth to your breathing. And walk your feet to your hands. Sit down, hands back, fingertips pointing towards you. Widen your elbows and then gather your elbows in to lift up into your heart. Widen the elbows, tuck the chin, round in, and then rising. And one more, rounding. Elbows in, rising. Pause. So the hips come in an inch up and an inch forward and then back. And an inch up and forward and back. One more. You're just making a little more space where you can and where you think you can't. And standing in your feet and standing in your hands, let your chest be broad. Let your body be long,
From your navel to your knees, reach forward. From your heart to your head, reach back. Let the chin rise, let the head be heavy. Press down into the hands. Stand in the heels and the base of your big toes. Moving through the jaw, through the face. Moving your eyeballs around under your eyelids.
And then rolling down.
Sitting tall, left leg straight. Wrap your left arm around your right shin and turn. And then left leg straight. Left knee bends. Turn right. Center. And turning to the right side. And center, and turning to the left side. So inhale at center, exhale as you turn. Let it get a little loose, like you were tightening a rubber band and then coming undone. Find staff pose. Legs out long, heart high, hands behind. Heels in, cobbler. Press your outer knees down. Be clear, be intentional. Outer knees down, heart comes up. To boat, float your feet and reach up. Rising, cobbler. Heels wide, sitting tall. Exhale, staff pose. Exhale, cobbler. To boat. To cobbler. To wide legs. To cobbler. To cobbler, to bow, palms to the other knees to your shoulders, and out, knees to your shoulders, and out, inhale knees in, exhale feet out. Cobbler. Sit up tall, chest broad, knees broad. Heels wide. Hands behind you to lead with your heart or fingertips or palms or forearms. Sit up tall, cobbler, feet together, press your knees wide, walk your hips towards your heels, press your outer knees down, draw your toes apart, be very strong in the legs, and find steady breath. On your inhale, fill your chest, and on your exhale, empty your navel, navel to spine. Outer knees pressed out. To staff. And sitting tall, tilt your cross-legged seat. Build your cross-legged seat.
Pause your plans. And with the body ready, we ready the sound. We become more familiar with our sound. We become less vain, less concerned. What does this sound like to anyone else? What does this sound like to me? Become more familiar with your own sound. So clear it out with the sound of E. It's 8 counts of E and 6 count inhale. Inhale to start. Keep inviting your sound with the pulse of hum, H-A-M. Hum, 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 hum. 3, 2, 1, and be still and feel. Invite the physical body to keep adjusting. Maybe you're a little taller, maybe you're a little softer, maybe you're tuned in more fully. And take it with you. Coming to stand, your playlist starts at nature. Feet just wider than hip distance. Palms together, thumbs at the top of your sternum, heels down, heart high. As you extend your arms to 60 degrees, your chin follows the tips of your thumbs and continues to follow as you bring thumbs to the chest. So inhale as you extend and exhale as you bring it in. Closing your eyes, feel the movement through your arms and your chest and your throat, opening the front and the back of your neck, all the way up under the point of your chin, the base of your skull, down into your heels and out through your toes. A hint of a smile, making an offering, receiving praise. Feel this.
Separate your hands at the top, three sips, bring it in. Heart up, chin in, reaching, heels down, toes long. And release the breath, hands coming down, let it go, be done. You are a vehicle of light. Bring it down to a cross-legged seat. Turn your palms open, sitting tall. Keep all the height you made through the throat, through the neck. Now turn it to the left and turn it to the right. Inhale left, exhale right, work here, extend your arms, inhaling left and exhaling right. Turn your thumbs back and let your shoulder blades slide towards the spine. Open from the center of your palms into your fingertips. Soften the skin around your eyes. Turn your eyes from corner to corner as you turn your chin. So it feels as though your eyes are turning you through your spine. Center, hands 60 degrees, inhale, chin up, three more sips in. Hold the breath, heart comes up, chin comes in. Trace your attention at the line of your spine. Where it's sticky, give it a little shimmy. Soften the shoulders, the neck, the head, shake out the fingertips, and then chin up, breath out, hands down. Down. Left shoulder to your ear and drop. Right to your ear, drop. Inhale, exhale, in, out. Feel the weight of your arms. Feel the weight of your elbows and your hands. Each one is an exhale. Each one is a release. Each one is a completion. A conclusion, a benediction, let it out of your body and keep going. Find the place that feels like it's done and keep going past that. Keep concluding. There's nothing you need to take forward from here. hand, shake your hand, shake your hand, shake your hand.
Roll your shoulders. And then build kneeling. So the blanket is under your shins and your knees and a block between your heels. Palms under your thighs, sitting tall. Find a whisper of ha. Right from your belly. Keep that breath, put your lips together, go out your nose. Float your palms over your thighs. Arms out long, turn your thumbs up, turn your thumbs wide. Roll your shoulder blades under your heart, a little arch of the back, tail back, heart up. Sit in your seat, reach your fingers forward. Now you may work right here, steady breath out the nose. Or drawing your shoulders back an inch. Reach your fingers forward. The chin lifts slightly. And we go. Sink into your hips. Trust your seat as your foundation, that the shoulders and the armpits stay wide, that the elbows are long, the finger joints even, the back of the neck and the base of the skull are long. Hands high, widening, chin up, three sips. Heart out, chin in, lift the pelvic floor. Trace the spine up through the body to the top of the head, little wriggle, loosen it, lift it. And then chin up, breath out, elbows down. Notice. Feel the quiet, the substance of that quiet, how quick it is to hold you and meet you. This is yours. Bring it back into your body. Come to lie down. Knees bent, feet flat, just as we began. Tap your feet. Tap your heels, wag your tail, settle. Left palm to the floor, right hand overhead. Draw your hands apart,
Square the hips and shoulders. And right hand down. Left hand overhead. Draw your hands apart. And down. Right hand overhead, right leg straightens. And then back to the ground. Left hand, left heel. And back down. Open the right side. Catch the right hand to the right shin. Left hand, left heel. And left hand to left shin. Open the right side. And close. Inhale, left. Exhale, close. Flex your feet. Reach into your heels. And continue. Eyes closed. Move from the very base of your navel. Back into the legs, back into the belly, back into the low body. We are light and we are form. Feel the weight of your legs. Feel the strength of your abdomen. Feel the intention that holds you there, that makes sense of this life. For three. For two. Good. Legs long. Turn your palms open. Loosen your feet side to side, your knees up and down, and your tail side. Bend your knees and make your way to a simple seat. Knees bend, feet flat. Hands behind you, fingers pointing in. Keep your elbows bent. And then widen your elbows. Wrap them in. Sit down in your seat and lift your heart. Bend your elbows wide. And then rise. One more time. So that you can lengthen from the front of your shoulder down the bicep, down into the base of your thumbs. And just, this can be enough. The chest is lifted, the seat is heavy, shoulder blades support your heart. Or walk the legs out, toes up. So if you did the vinyasa yesterday, this shape of the arch through the spine, the lift through the navel, this is what we were building. Little bend in the elbows. Keep sitting down to rise up. The chin lifts. Four count in, four count out. That's our breath. As you're ready, the back of the head drops down. You close your eyes. If this is too much for your body,
Bend your elbows and put your elbows down, put your palms flat, make a fish. If that's too much for your body, put your blocks under the back and the back of your head. Steady breathing. Give it time. Bend your elbows around your back. Walk your hands up, find staff pose.
Hands heavy, tuck of the chin.
Let the weight of your forehead open the back of your neck. Now the inhale lifts so softly. Exhale, fold back up. And just halfway up and halfway down.
And in staff, be still, neutral, be done. Shoulder blades back underneath your heart, sitting tall. Feel the length of your neck. Roll the shoulders, shake out the hands, last place to go. Kneeling. So the blanket, if you use it, a block between your heels too, if it's best. And if kneeling doesn't work, hop onto your chair, coming onto the front edge of your chair if you like. Hands on your thighs, inhale yourself forward, exhale it back. Inhale forward, exhale back. So hands may rest on thighs or float an inch off. Or hold opposite wrist. Or hands up high, thumbs point back. Inhale forward, exhale back. As you come forward, fill your chest, a sensation of expansion. As you go back, empty from the navel and feel the navel gather, that we open and we close. We are both. We are substance and we are light. Just play with that experience. And on your inhale, bring your attention to the top of your head and your exhale down to the base of your spine. And as you move between the two, feel a line or a bead of light through the spine. Inhale, chin up, three sips, fill it. Catch it, heart up, chin in, lift the pelvic floor. Your attention up through the spine, a little shimmy, out to the fingertips. Chin up, breath out, elbows down, notice. You may sit still, reside in what you made, or come to lie down entirely. Today I will sit. Deepening your breathing, your hands overhead, wherever you've gone. To bring yourself to a tall, cross-legged seat. When we finish in our own sound, the body prepared, the spine tall. Om is the sound of all things. A in the belly, U in the chest, M in the head. clearing, if you feel the breath, the sound at the beginning a bit rough, use the repetition to create clarity in your sound. That rough quality is not the voice. That rough quality is very often the mind. Let the sound move through you. Inhale. Stillness. This is where the change occurs. This is where new language can form for how you greet and address yourself throughout the day. Where new stories are made, revised. This stillness is so powerful. Whenever you practice, stay as long as you can. And when your time comes to its end, sweep wide, reach tall. Palms come together. The thumbs to the forehead center. I bow to this great sweet sound within me. Sat Nam. Eight count Sat, two count Nam. Inhale. Sat. Sunday, or whenever you choose to practice this. This is our final week for Vishuddha, for the throat, for the voice, for our sense of self-mastery. So dive in, use it well, be back on Tuesday at noon, Thursday at noon. If you didn't get a chance to come to the vinyasa yesterday, really this lift through the navel to open and hold the heart. We made it in on the belly, we made it standing, we made it on the back. Keep feeling this space because it's the base that holds up the sound. replay it anytime. The first 30 minutes are absolutely all you need. So make it yours. I will see you so soon. Thank you for your practice. I'm off to the park. Until then.